Tuesday, August 6, 2019, 7:29 a.m. Pacific time. Good morning. I'm over here in Luke 4. Luke 4. Let's start in verse 12. And Jesus answering said unto him, the devil who was tempting him after he was led out into the desert to be tempted by the devil. And Jesus answering, and this is the end of that. And Jesus answering said unto him, the devil, it is said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And when the devil had ended all the temptation, he departed from him for a season. And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee, and there went out a fame of him through all the region round about. And he taught in their synagogues, that's the Jewish synagogue, being glorified of all. And when he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, and stood up for to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Esaias. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written in the book of Isaiah. Okay? And this is what Jesus says. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Okay, let's read that again. The Spirit of the Lord was upon Jesus. This is what he was saying. He was reading this from the book of Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me. But this is Luke 4. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives. Not only to preach the gospel, but to preach deliverance to the captives. That's our job, church. Okay? It's more than just preaching the gospel. It's all inclusive, okay? He hath anointed me to preach the gospel. Read at the end of the gospels where the Lord told us to go and do what he told us to do, okay? Heal the sick, raise the dead, all those things. It's not just about preaching the gospel and staying within the four walls of the church and hovering down and hunkering down waiting for Jesus to come. Okay? The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And he closed the book, and he gave it again to the minister, and sat down, and the eyes of all them that were in the synagogue were fastened on him. And he began to say unto them, this day is the scripture fulfilled in your ears. And all bear him witness and wondered at the gracious words which proceeded out of his mouth. And they said, is not this Joseph's son? And he said unto them, ye will surely say unto me this proverb, physician, heal thyself. Whatsoever we have heard done in Capernaum, do also here in my country. And he said, verily I say unto you, no prophet is accepted in his own country. But I tell you of a truth, many widows were in Israel in the days of Elias, when the heaven was shut up, 3 years and 6 months, when great famine was throughout all the land. But unto none of them was Elias sent, save unto Sarepta, a city of Sidon, to a woman that was a widow. And many lepers were in Israel in the time of Elias the prophet, and none of them was cleansed, save Naaman and Syrian. And all they in the synagogue, when they heard these things, were filled with wrath, and rose up and thrust him out of the city, and led him unto the brow of the hill whereon their city was built, and that they might cast him down headlong. But he, Jesus, passing through the midst of them, went his way, and came down to Capernaum, a city of Galilee, and taught them on the Sabbath days. And they were astonished at his doctrine, for his word was with power. And in the synagogue there was a man which had a spirit of an unclean devil, and cried out with a loud voice, saying, Let us alone. What have we to do with thee, thou Jesus of Nazareth? Art thou come to destroy us? I know thee who thou art, the Holy One of God. And Jesus rebuked him, saying, Hold thy peace, come out of him. And when the devil had thrown him in the midst, he came out of him and hurt him not. And they were all amazed, and spake among themselves, saying, What a word is this? For with authority and power he commandeth the unclean spirits, and they come out. We need to command with power, people. We need to, with authority and power, command the devil, okay? And the fame of him went out into every place of the country round about. And he arose out of the synagogue and entered into Simon's house. And Simon's wife's mother was taken with a great fever, and they besought him for her. And he stood over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. And immediately she rose and ministered unto them. Now when the sun was setting, all they that had sick with divers diseases brought them unto him, and he laid his hands on every one of them and healed them. And devils also came out of many, crying out and saying, Thou art Christ, the Son of God. And he, rebuking them, suffered them not to speak, for they knew that he was Christ. And when it was day, he departed and went into a desert place. And the people sought him, and came unto him, and stayed him, that he should not depart from them. And he said unto them, I must preach the kingdom of God to other cities also, for therefore am I sent. And he preached in the synagogue of Galilee. Father, thank you for this word. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for your power. Satan, I bind you in the name of Jesus Christ. I cast you out, down, and under my feet in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, fill us with your Holy Spirit, your love, your peace, your joy. Bless our day with protection, health, and healing. Be healed in Jesus' name. And every need met in Jesus Christ's holy name. Amen. Okay, everybody, have a great day. God bless. Bye-bye.